In today's short video, we're going to take this pH probe, couple it to our Arduino Uno board, and we're going to go through the whole process. This video will only focus on the pH probe and the settings around that. In future videos, we will then take this pH probe, add it to our temperature sensor, upload the values to ThingSpeak, and you would be able to look at it on your cell phone. We will also do videos where we then switch relays on and off. Maybe you can switch pumps on and off, lights, anything that you want. We will also do other sensors like light intensity sensors, float sensors, and so on. There's a whole range of sensors that we can use with the Arduino microcontroller. Please remember that this is a whole series of videos on the Arduino microcontroller in aqua and hydroponics. We use this sketch of DFrobot as our system block diagram. You can see your pH probe here in the water that you want to measure the pH of, and then that sensor is coupled to this analog interface board. This analog interface board will get power from the Arduino. You can see 5 volt there and ground there, and then the output of this board is an analog signal that we're going to put for this project on A1, our analog port A1. The Arduino will then interpret that analog value and give out a pH value. This is just to show you the kit that you must get for this project. So there will be 2 7 pH buffer solutions, 2 4 pH buffer solution bottles in the kit. You'll have your pH probe, your analog interface board, and a few cables. It comes in a box like that. This is just to show you what I'm going to do in the software. In the software, we'll get an analog value, a specific analog value, when we put the probe in a pH 4 buffer solution. Then we will get a specific analog value when we put the probe in a pH 7 buffer. And with the equation for a straight line, we can then from those two points determine any other point on this line. So that will be done in software. Again, I've written the code for you. You don't have to worry about that at all. Let's have a quick look at our different components. Of course, we've got our Arduino Uno board, and we've got our analog interface board. It's coupled. We'll talk about the connections a little bit later. Then you've got this, your probe that just fits with this fitting into your analog interface board. This is very handy because if you don't want your probe all the time in your system, you can just remove the probe, leave the rest of the hardware there, and then just put your probe back when you want to take a measurement. And then of course the 7 pH buffer and the 4 pH buffer solution. So here's our Arduino sketch. Again, a very simple program that I've written for you. Maybe at this stage we must start to look at the structure of Arduino program, and that's also very easy. At the start of the program, you will define certain variables and you will include libraries if necessary. In this program, there's no libraries included. Then you've got a setup part. The setup will run only once in the Arduino. It's basically things that you need to tell the Arduino microcontroller only once. And then you've got your main loop. Like you can see, the main loop in this case, very simple. All my code I write in this structure, where I call a function from the main loop. So it will go and do that function, and then it will come back to the main loop. The main loop will run over and over again in your Arduino as long as it's powered up. I call this function. This function, just go and get the pH value, and I can just scroll up. here's the function. So I will just read and average the sensor reading over 10 readings, and then I'll do that calculation in order to determine the specific point on the linear line. What you must note is that we do not do any temperature compensation in this project. So we don't compensate for any temperature changes with the pH. So in the first comment below the video, you will find the code. You can just copy it from there and paste it in your Arduino IDE. Remember, if you don't know how to get your IDE, this software, then you can just check the first Arduino video where I tell you exactly how to get access to this Arduino IDE program. So the next step will be to program your Arduino microcontroller. So always two things that you check. You check if under tools, you check if you've got the correct board selected, and then you must also check that it's connected. I haven't connected my Arduino to the port, so let's do that now. So now if I go under tools, I will find the Arduino under the correct port there. So the board must be the Uno and the port must be the correct port there for the Arduino selected. In many cases, there will be more than one port showing up here, and then you just select the one with the Arduino Uno on it. Then you can compile and see if there's any errors in your sketch. So the sketch will compile. The first time that it compiles, it will take a few seconds, but not that long. So it's compiling at the moment. It's done compiling, no errors. So then you can just upload it to the board by pressing this upload button. It will compile and upload immediately. Done uploading. So now that software is running on your board. You can then go to tools and serial monitor. On your serial monitor, you'll see two values. The first one is your analog reading. That's the analog reading from the analog card, and then the interpreted pH of that pH value that is calculated by the Arduino microcontroller. You will see if you go to the top of your sketch, there's two analog values there. Now I'm going to show you now how to do the calibration, and it's very easy. You take your buffer solution, and let's take the 7 first. So what you do is you just pull out your probe from this little bottle. You can just loosen it a little bit, and then you pull it out there. Right. Then you rinse your probe in clean water. Shake it off a little bit. Then we can take our 7 buffer and we put our probe in there, and I'm just going to hold it there. So now you can still see, you can see the measurements going on. So it's supposed to be 7 at the moment. So I'm going to change my value now. There you can see it's 7. The manufacturer suggests that you leave it in the buffer solution for at least a minute for it to stabilize. And there you can see it's almost 7, so it's actually very well calibrated. If there were a difference between this value and that one there for the 7, then we would have changed this value to the value that you read here. But you can see 3.22 and the 7 pH, that's absolutely correct. So I'm now going to remove it from the 7 buffer. And I'm going to just rinse it again. And now I'll take it to the 4 buffer. Let's put it in the four, and I'm just going to hold it like that. And let's see. Right, so it's moving towards four here. You can see our values moving towards four. 4.03. Right, so again, very close. You can see this value, 429, very close to that 431. 430, so it will stabilize within a short period of time. I just want to show you, let's change this to say 400, and let's upload that to our board. So it's uploading, and it's done uploading. Let's just open our serial monitor again, and we will see now that our readings are out. Readings are not correct, but the value that you see here is the value that must be in that place in order for this to read correctly. So you can see we've got it in the 4 buffer, but it's reading 2.8. So I must change this value here to correlate with this one here. And let's make that then 430. And let's upload it again. So it's compiling and uploading. Done uploading. Open our serial monitor. And we should see a value very close to 4. There you can see it. 4 pH. And that was then the calibration of the pH probe. So now your system are ready to use, and you can use it to measure the pH in your aquaponic or hydroponic system. So in our next videos, we will take this probe and we will add it to our temperature sensor, and we will also then communicate those values to ThingSpeak. And from ThingSpeak, you will be able to look at those values on your cell phone. In future projects, we're also going to add relays to the system so that you can switch on and off pumps, as well as other sensors like humidity, EC, and a few other sensors, maybe float sensors, anything that you need to control your aquaponic or hydroponic system. So if you want updates on those, please check the notification bell as well when you subscribe. On this channel, we do all sorts of stuff concerning aquaponics and hydroponics, not only Arduino videos. So if you like this video, please give it a like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.